Well, no country in the Western Hemisphere has failed more completely in more ways than Venezuela, sadly. It has a lot going for it. It had a huge middle class. It has, of course, the world's largest proven oil reserves. Today, it can't even feed itself. There's no toilet paper some days in Caracas. They're eating zoo animals. What happened? Well, you know what happened. They implemented socialism, and there were obvious and predictable and disastrous consequences. But that's not the whole story of what happened there. 6 years ago, the government of Venezuela passed a gun ban specifically designed to disarm the public. It, of course, did not make people safer. Venezuela is one of the highest murder rates in the world. That wasn't the point of it. The point was to make the people powerless, and it definitely did that. As one terrified Venezuelan put it, quote, people never would have believed they needed to defend themselves against the government. But, of course, they did. In the past 2 years, almost 200 protesters, pro-democracy protesters, have been murdered by the security forces of dictator Nicolas Maduro. The government still has guns, of course. Authoritarians aren't stupid. They never give up their guns. That's rule one. Well, that principle applies just as well to the United States as it does to failing socialist states. In New Jersey, ordinary citizens can go to prison for possessing gun magazines that hold too many rounds. But lawmakers there just changed the law to ensure it doesn't apply to police. They know larger magazines can be helpful for defense. That's why their bodyguards still have them. Regular citizens, though, have to fend for themselves. Bernie Carrick is a former NYPD commissioner, and he joins us tonight. Bernie, thanks very much for coming on. So there are two parts to the story. The first part is the state of New Jersey, for a time, made it a crime for its own officers off-duty, included off-duty, to have magazines that I think hold more than 10 rounds. What was the thinking behind that?
Well, honestly, Tucker, it was worse than that. Basically, they did it for the entire state of New Jersey. 10-round capacity or less only. Anything above that is a crime.
Yes.
They did it for the whole state. When they did that, and basically, it was a cunning way to attack the legal gun owners because
right.
You have 8 million handguns in New York, in New Jersey. You have probably another 2 million anti-assault weapons, not assault weapons, but semi-automatic weapons,
right.
Rifles. They have, capacities of more than 10 rounds, and the government took that power away, which means you have to destroy the magazines or you have to alter them, and most of them can't be altered. So you basically, you make those guns useless. When they did this, they also added off-duty police officers, which is completely bizarre. And it's another assault on the Second Amendment. But more importantly, you have off-duty cops that many of them carry their on-duty weapon off-duty.
Of course.
If it's a 9mm, it has 12 rounds in a magazine or 13 or 14, it now becomes illegal. So God forbid that cop off duty gets involved in a shooting and he's held criminally liable. He could be held civilly liable. It's a major, major problem. It's
dangerous. I want to go back to something you just said a second ago because it gets to the heart of what makes me nervous about this whole conversation and why I'm starting to suspect the other side is arguing in bad faith. If you're worried about gun violence, and I think everybody is, including me, for sure, you go after the small number of people who are committing it, who are criminals and crazy people. You wouldn't intentionally target legal gun owners who are likely to be law-abiding and, in fact, statistically are law-abiding. So why go after them? What's that about?
That's about taking the guns. That's about taking guns. That's the only thing I can think of. These are legal, law-abiding citizens that have been vetted, that have been background checked, that have all the stuff they need to purchase the weapons. Well, the governor decided we're going to take every magazine in excess of 10 rounds. And basically what that does, that's a lot of magazines.
But why would you? So your goal, if that's your plan, is to disarm legal gun owners, to take the resources from going after, from stop and frisk, trying to find people who shouldn't have guns who possess them, criminals, and go to legal gun owners, it's not really about reducing the crime rate, is it?
No, absolutely not. Because, the bad guys don't care about your gun law. They don't give a damn about that gun law. And they're going to have magazines that have double the capacity. It doesn't make any difference to them. It's not going to have any impact on reducing crime. So I don't know what the purpose was, But I do know right now, even as of now, and this broke on Thursday or Friday when the Bergen County prosecutor put out a memo to the cops saying, be careful because of this rule, of this law. Even today, as we speak, they've revised, there's a revision to the law, but the governor hasn't signed it. So you still have cops in the state of New Jersey right now off duty. If they're carrying a magazine in excess of 10 rounds, they are violating New Jersey state law.